how our constitutional fathers were dedicatedly involved in making constitution of India.
सारे उपस्थित सदस्यों को सुप्रभात। आज हम सभी यहाँ पर एकत्रित हुए हैं भारतीय संविधान के निर्माण हेतु। हम इस विषय पर प्रकाश डालेंगे कि कैसे संवैधानिक पिता समर्पित रूप से भारतीय संविधान बनाने में शामिल थे।
पार्ट वन। इन द कमिंग सीन डॉक्टर भीमराव अंबेडकर विल इंट्रोड्यूस और सजेस्ट द रिजोल्यूशन ऑफ प्रोविजन टू द शेड्यूल्ड एंड बैकवर्ड क्लासेस which is a part of today's constitution, provided in Article 15 and 16 of the constitution. So let's take a look on Ambedkar's statement regards to same.
आने वाले दृश्य में बाबा साहेब अंबेडकर अनुसूचित और पिछड़े वर्गों के लिए आरक्षण प्रावधान पेश करेंगे या सुझाव देंगे जो संविधान के अनुच्छेद 15 और 16 में प्रदान किए गए और वो आज के संविधान का एक हिस्सा है। तो आइए उसी के संबंध में अंबेडकर के बयान पर एक नजर डालें।
I would like to congratulate and thanks to all the members present here. We are here to make a constitution of India for our India's sustainable future. The foremost thing that we need is freedom. As someone has said, freedom, nothing is more important than the freedom. Let's hope and pray, as a result of the labor of this Constituent Assembly, we shall achieve that freedom, and we shall be proud of that. Now, I call B.R. Ambedkar to take the floor.
Mr. Chairman, as we have been witnessing that other minorities have got privilege in the past for a long time, for example, Muslims were receiving privilege since 1892, Christians from the constitution of 1920, but the scheduled caste has received it from 1935 constitution and practically from 1937, which were also seized by 1939. Therefore, the scheduled caste has received benefits only for 2 years by then, and hence I believe that they should get reservation for a longer time.
I request Bhimrao Ambedkar to form an independent committee for that matter.
I am ready to take the responsibility as directed by the chairman.
Now I call Rajkumari Ambedkar to present her view.
Sabhapati Mahoday, is committee ka sabse pehla aur aham kaam yah hona chahiye, woh koi aise raaste sujhaye jisse samanya minorities को अलग थलग करने की जो रिवाज है उन्हें खत्म कर दी जाए। इनमें माइनॉरिटीज ग्रुप, अंडर प्रिविलेज लोग, तमिल और औरतें भी हैं। मेरे हिसाब से औरतें इस ग्रुप की सबसे बड़ी माइनॉरिटी इकाई है।
सर चेयरमैन, आई वुड लाइक टू ऐड फ्यू पॉइंट्स ऑन दैट मैटर। फॉर हाउ मेनी डेज वी विल प्रोवाइड दिस प्रोटेक्शन, वी विल हैव टू डिसाइड व्हेन इट शैल बी टर्मिनेटेड।
Now I call Sardar Patel ji to kindly take the floor and add some view on this regard.
Thank you, Chairman sir, for providing opportunity to add some thought in this matter. Khatra to yeh bhi hai ki agar humne kisi ek vishesh varg ko arakshan pradan kiya, to anya log bhi arakshan ki mang karenge aur is karan Bharat mein jatiwad ki lehar phailti hi jayegi.
Scene 2. In the next day, sitting of Constituent Assembly, Patel ji and Ambedkar ji are presenting their views on inclusive provision of fundamental rights. So let's move to the House proceeding.
भाग दो। अगले दिन संविधान सभा की बैठक में पटेल जी और अंबेडकर जी मौलिक अधिकारों के समाज विरोधी प्रावधानों पर अपने विचार प्रस्तुत करते हैं। तो चलिए सदन की कार्यवाही पर चलते हैं।
Now I request Sardar Patel ji to kindly present the clause for fundamental rights as a chairman of advisory committee of fundamental rights and minorities.
Sir, I beg to move 2 clauses for that regard. Firstly, states shall not discriminate any citizen on ground of sex, caste, religion. And secondly, no citizen shall on any ground of religion, race, caste, sex, place of birth or any of them to access to shops, public restaurant, hotels and public places, or the uses of well, tank, bathing huts and public places.
Mr. Chairman, I would like to comment that the idea of making a gift of fundamental rights to every individual is no doubt very laudable. The question is how to make them effective. The prevalent view is that once the rights are enacted in law, they are safeguarded, as experience proves. Rights are protected not only by law, but by the society and moral conscience of the society. Social conscience is the only safeguard of all the rights, fundamental or non-fundamental.
Scene 3, flag. In the next part, let's see the true color, size and India's identity as introduced by Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru.
भाग 3, ध्वज. अगले भाग में पंडित नेहरू द्वारा पेश किए गए असली रंग, आकार और भारत की पहचान को देखते हैं।
Now I call Pandit Nehru to kindly present their resolution.
Mr. President, it is my proud privilege to move the following resolution. Resolve that the national flag of India shall be horizontal tricolor of deep saffron, white and dark green in equal proportion. In the center of the white band, there shall be a wheel in navy blue to represent the chakra. The design of the wheel shall be that of the wheel which appears as an abacus of the Sarnath, the land capital of Ashoka.
Sir, I will talk about the provision of citizenship. Every person born or naturally in India, according to law, shall be citizen of India.
Sir, क्या यूनियन में जिनका भी जन्म हुआ है, उन सभी को citizenship और उसके फायदे मिलेंगे?
जरा इन शब्दों पे भी गौर फरमाए महोदय. Subject to jurisdiction, ambassadors और foreigners के बच्चे हमारे नागरिक नहीं कहलाएंगे.
मान लीजिए कोई जापानी महिला यहाँ से गुजर रही है और उसको बच्चा हो जाता है तो क्या होगा?
Sir, as per our Supreme Court, it was said that any casual visitor will not fall in this clause.
What happens when a man not passing through but stay for trade or other purposes?
महोदय, मेरा प्रस्ताव यह है कि हमें इस विषय पर अलग से चर्चा करनी चाहिए.
I agree, Chair, that we don't need to manufacture nationality over my head.
I will request all the lawyers and jurists of the men, they are the members of this house, to pay attention on this clause, and a committee of 3 lawyers will be formed.
Sir, I suggest that in addition to 3 lawyers, one man of common sense should also be added.
And I do not exclude lawyer from the category of common people.
भाग 5, संविधान की प्रस्तावना.
Now I call Pandit Nehru to take the floor.
Mr. Chairman, I beg to move with the resolution which would be our aim and objective of the Constitution. Mr. Chairman, the resolution which I am placing defines our aim, describes our way in which we are going. The resolution that I place before you is in a nature of a pledge, and hope the House will pass this resolution, which is of a special nature. Sir, I beg to move, first, this Constituent Assembly declare that it's firmly, solemnly resolved to proclaim India as an independent sovereign republic. Second, where shall be guaranteed to secure all people of India justice, social, economical and political, equality of status, opportunity and freedom of thought, expression, belief, vocation, association, action and worship.
Scene 6, Conclusive remarks by Dr. B. R. Ambedkar and Rajendra Prasad.
बहुत अच्छे बी आर अम्बेडकर और राजेंद्र प्रसाद की निर्णायक टिप्पणी.
Now I call B. R. Ambedkar to kindly present the conclusive statement and address the House.
Mr. Chairman, looking back on the work of the Constituent Assembly, it is now 2 years, 11 months and 17 days since it first met on 9 December 1946. During this period, the Constituent Assembly has altogether had 11 sessions. These 11 sessions of Constituent Assembly have consumed 165 days. Out of this, the Assembly spent 114 days for consideration of the draft constitution. I would like to thank all the members of the House and my beloved friend for helping in making such a dynamic or living document which will decide India's future steps.
Now, hereby on today, 26 November 1949, the constitution is adopted for India, that is Bharat. Jai Hind.